Where can you win $32,000 on the turn of a card? Right here on Card Shark. And now, the host of Card Shark, Bill Rafferty.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Why, thank you. Thank you. Thank you. What a nice show. Thank you, everybody. Welcome. Welcome, everybody, to Card Sharks, where you can win a fortune on the turn of a single card. And to guarantee that our players get a fair deal, let's meet our lovely dealers. Here they come. That's Lacey Pemberton and Susanna Williams. Yes.
Oh,
how are you? Nice to see you.
So nice.
Thank you.
Oh,
I love this.
Wonderful.
This is the first. Yeah, this is the first show of our new season, and I'm excited. But I'm a little bit nervous.
A little nervous?
Yeah.
Okay, so are we.
I think I'm going to get through it a little bit.
We'll do it together.
Will you do it together?
That's
okay.
Deal out those cards, ladies.
Right. Here we are right now. Susanna's going to be dealing out the red cards on the top, and Lacey will be dealing out the blue cards on the bottom. No need to wait any longer. Let's meet today's card sharks. Hello, Mel.
Hi,
hello,
how you doing?
Tina. Mel, you won the toss of the coin backstage, and you're going to be playing from our championship position. Tell us a little bit about yourself, sir.
Yeah, hi. My name is Mel Davis. I'm a flight attendant for a major airline. I'm from Detroit, and I'm ready to play card sharks.
Good. That's why you're here. Good for you. Hello, Tina.
Hi. I'm Tina LaFon. I'm a junior at California State University, Fullerton, and I also manage a sun tanning center.
Uh-huh. What are you majoring, Tina?
I'm majoring in education.
Majoring in education?
Uh-huh.
Good for you. Have you both cut your cards backstage?
We have.
We're ready to play. I want to wish you good luck. Let me quickly tell the folks at home how our game is played. The object of the game is to work your way across this board by predicting whether each of these cards will be higher or lower than the card that precedes it. However, before you can start calling the cards, you must answer one of our high-low questions, and the first question is going to go to Mel. Mel, we surveyed 100 garbage men, and we asked them, have you ever given a girl a present that you found in someone's trash? How many garbage men admitted that they have?
Okay. I can't imagine a garbage man picking up trash and giving it as a gift. I just find that hard to believe, although I realize there are some weirdos out there. I think that's going to be a fairly low number, Bill. I would think 10.
10. 10, that is low. That is a low number. What do you say, Tina?
Oh, I think that's even going to be lower because I don't know how they would do it. They get in the garbage thing and then it goes up on top. I don't know how they would dig it out.
So
it's got to be lower than that.
You're going lower than
lower.
10, but just for your information at home, if you are dating a garbage man and you're getting a gift that smells a little funny, it's the thought that counts, all right? Anyway, the actual number of garbage men who have given a girl a present they found in someone's trash is 30. It's lower. It's higher.
Weirdo.
So, that means that, Mel, you've got the high-low question right. That means you're going to look at this base card, and because you've got that question right, you can change it. If you wish, let's take a look at it right now. It's a 7.
I would like to change that.
Yeah,
I don't blame
you.
Get rid of it.
Susanna gives it to me. That 7 now becomes a 2.
Okay.
Good job.
All right. It's going to be higher.
Higher than a 2. A 7.
He's going
higher than a 7. A king.
Bring it down.
Lower than a king. A 6. A 6.
Okay, freeze.
He's going to freeze. Whoa. I thought you were going to freeze at the 7. Mel is freezing. He's going to protect his position, and he keeps Tina away from the cards, and he realizes that if he gets the next high-low question correct, he goes back to the board and changes that 6. Let's go over here to Tina. Here's question number 2 for you, Tina. We surveyed 100 single women, and we asked them, have you ever lied to a man when he asked you how many men there were before him?
Yes, definitely.
How many single women admitted they have lied to a man about how many men there were before him?
Lots of women. I think that they like to make guys just a little bit jealous, and doing that, that'll get their ego right away. I think that's about 72 at least.
72?
72.
That's a high number. That's a high number. What do you say, Mel? Higher or lower?
Well, I know that there are a lot of women out there that might be tempted to do that, but whether they would actually tell the truth about it is the bottom line. I think it's going to be a lower number.
You're saying it's a lower number?
I think it's a lower number.
You're a single guy.
I'm a single guy.
You think you've been told any stories?
Yeah, a couple.
All right. The actual number of single women who have lied to a man about how many men there were before is 27. It is lower. It is lower. So Mel goes to the cards over here. He is
changing
up the six.
Card.
Change
get
that
out of
six.
It.
That six now becomes an eight. We've got an eight. Playing off the eight.
Okay, all right, okay. Higher, bring it
He's
higher.
Going higher than the higher. Eight. If he is right, he will win game number one. Higher than an eight? It is higher than an eight. Wonderful. Terrific. That was good. You've won game number one. You've got $100, and we'll be back with game number two right after this commercial message. Whoa. Back to Card Sharks. Susanna's dealing out the cards for the second game right now. We're getting to go to game two at this very moment. Mel is already have one game ahead of Tina. He's got $100 in his pocket. The first contestant to win two games, they win the match. They go on to play the money cards. And if you think this has been exciting, wait till we get to the money cards. However, first things first, game number two, question number one, back to Mel. We surveyed 100 people and we asked them, should professional athletes be required to take tests that test for illegal drugs? How many people said athletes should be required to take drug tests? Sign of the 80s in this question.
Hey,
what do you think, Mel?
Yeah, I agree. That is a sign of the 80s. Things being as they are, I am not I'm not an athlete, and I'm not into drugs. I would think that it's going to be a very high number of people that would...
said that athletes should be required to take drug tests?
Okay. I would say about 80 people said that.
80 people out of 100. Tina, how about you? Higher or lower?
That's a really good number, but I think that it's going to be... well, it depends on if they told the athletes or not, because the athletes are really resistant.
How many people said athletes should be required to take drug tests?
I think it's just a little bit higher.
We're going higher than 80.
A little bit higher.
Higher than 80. Who knows? The actual number of people who said athletes should be required to take drug tests is 82. It is a little bit higher. Good. Good question. Good answer. Good answer. All right, Tina, you've got the high-low question correct. Here's your base card. You can change it if you want. Let's take a look at it right now. It is a 4.
No, I want to go higher than that.
Higher than a 4. A 5.
Higher
than a 5. A 9.
I think I'm going to freeze
She's going to freeze. She's going to freeze and protect her position. A little conservative here. Keeping Mel away from the cards. She realizes she's getting this next question. If she gets it right, she can change that 9. And Tina needs this game to stay in. Tina, we surveyed 100 bachelors, and we asked them, would you marry a woman who told you that she never wanted to have children? How many bachelors said they would marry a woman who never wanted to have children?
Well, this is the 80s, and a lot of women are planning on having careers instead of children and choosing that. And I think a lot of men are a little bit on the selfish side, and they want their money to themselves and not spend it on the kids. So I think that's going to be, just about 43.
You're saying
43 out of 100. Yeah.
Mel, higher or lower? What do you say here?
I think it's going to be higher, Bill. I think that they're going to be, it's going to be a higher number.
You're going to say it's higher than 43. The actual number of bachelors who would marry a woman who never wanted to have children is 30. It is not higher. It is lower.
Yeah.
So, Tina's strategy pays off. She's
All
working
right,
off the 9.
You can change it.
Wants to change the 9. The 9 now becomes a 3.
Excellent.
Higher than a 3.
Definitely.
A king.
Lower
than a king is
All
for the
way.
Game and the tie.
All the way.
A 6. Wonderful. There you go. Tina's got $100. She's just tied it up. And when we come back after this message from your folks at home, we're going to be playing the tiebreaker. We'll be right back. Wasn't too bad, was it? We are in the midst. We're going to a tiebreaker right now because Tina has just tied the match up. She has $100 in her pocket, And Susanna's dealing out the cards right now for the tiebreaker. We play the tiebreaker with three cards and a maximum of three questions. And the first question in the tiebreaker goes to Mel. You ready,
okay,
Mel?
Okay, yes, I am.
We surveyed 100 people who have been fired from a job, and we asked them, did you deserve to be fired? How many people admitted they deserved it?
Well,
have you ever been fired?
I've never been. Once, a long, long time ago. And I don't think I deserved it then either, but I'm gonna say that that's going to be a relatively low number. I don't think that that many people really feel that they deserve to be fired. I think that's probably going to be around 18.
18. That is low. That is low. How about you, Tina?
Okay.
Higher or lower?
I think that it's just a little bit higher because some people do think that there's extenuating circumstances where they might have deserved it and they might admit it. So it's just a little higher.
All right, a little higher. The actual number of people who said they deserve to be fired from the job is 22. It is higher. It is higher.
Okay.
So, Tina, get this shot of the board first. We take a look at the base card. Change it if you wish. A queen.
No, no, no.
Lower than a queen.
Lower.
A three.
Lower.
Higher for the game and the match. A jet. Congratulations. That is wonderful. Congratulations. Well, Mel. Mel, you were there to the end.
It was fun.
You were an excellent contestant.
Thank you.
We had a lot of fun having you here on Card Sharks. We've got some lovely parting gifts for you backstage, and thank you so much for being here.
My pleasure.
Take care, Mel.
Bye-bye.
Come on over here, Tina. Good to see you. Right there. There's the mic. You. Give her a round of applause. This lady played it out. Played it out. Wonderful. What did you think going into the tiebreaker? Do you think you have a chance?
Of course. You always have a chance.
I like that attitude. Okay, here we are. We're going to be playing the money cards right now from a new deck of cards that Lacey and Susanna will be dealing out. And what we're going to do right now is tell you how to play the money cards. The $200 you've already won is yours to keep. We're going to start you out with some new money to bet with. We'll start you out on the bottom line with $200. You may bet your way across the board by calling high and low. When we get to the second line, we're going to give you $400 additional betting money. You bet your way across that line. Remember, minimum bets are $50, except when we get to the big bet. That's the top line where you must wager at least half your dollars. Now, don't forget, you're going to have the opportunity to change one card on each line from the cards that Lacey is dealing out on stage left over here. You ready to do it? That's all there is to it.
Oh, of course I am. I'm always ready.
All right, let's get this lady started. Let's give her $200.
Yeah.
She's got her $200. I'm going to tell you one thing. You play your cards right, you can turn $200 into $32,000.
Okay.
Here's your base card.
I'm ready.
Let's take a look at it right now. It's an eight.
Okay, I want to change that card.
Which card do you want?
I want to take number three.
Take card number three. Let's do some good work here. This eight now becomes a six.
Okay.
A little bit of help. A little bit of help. $200 playing off the six.
I want to bet $100 higher.
$100 higher than a six? It is higher than a six.
Okay, ready to go.
$300.
$250
lower than a jack. It's an eight.
Okay, that's
ooh.
Okay.
Listen, good card to play off. You have $50 to bet with. Come on.
Okay, I want all of it higher.
All of it higher.
Wait.
That person you hear hollering right now, that's my producer, because you said higher than an ace. We know that there is nothing higher than an ace. You meant lower than an ace.
Of course I
you
did.
You got the king. It's my mistake. I'm going to give you their money right now, okay?
Okay.
So you got good for you.
Yeah.
Good for you.
All right.
You've got $100. Uh-huh. We're going to give you $400 additional betting money. We're going to move this king up here. This is your base card. You now have $500, and you're playing off the king.
Okay.
Let's go.
I'm ready. Here we go. I want to go $450 lower than the king.
$450 lower than a king. A five.
Yeah.
Excellent.
Okay.
$950 off the five.
All right. I want to take $700 and go higher than that five.
$700 higher than a five. A king! $1,650.
Okay. I'm already now. I want to give...
$1,650.
I want to go... $1,500 lower than the king.
$1,500 lower than the king?
$1,500
Do you
lower.
Know this is a $3,000 bet?
Of course.
Okay, $1,500 lower than a king. A seven! Excellent! $3,150.
Okay.
Here's the seven.
I
$3,000.
Like to get rid of that card, and I would like to take number two.
Number two now becomes a three. Now, Tina, you have $3,150. You must wager at least $1,575 on this.
I'm going to take all of it and go higher.
All of it.
All of it.
All of it. Higher than a three. A ten. Oh, that was terrific. Wonderful. You know what? You now have $6,500. And when we come back right after this commercial, we're going to meet a new challenger, Vecina. We'll be right back.
Homeowner.
Go on, I want to get some more games on. Let's meet our new challenger. Come on in, Clay. Good to see you. Why don't you introduce yourself, Clay?
All right, my name's Clay Dial. I'm from Fayetteville, Arkansas, where I attend the University of Arkansas as a senior psychology major.
Well, good. It's good to have you here with us.
Well, thank you.
You've already cut your cards backstage.
Yes, sir.
And who's dealing out the cards? Susanna's dealing out the cards right now. Let's get on to our game. Here it is. Question number one. Game one goes to our champion, Tina. We surveyed 100 married women and we asked them, have you ever had an extramarital affair? How many married women admitted they have had an affair?
Okay, I don't think women are promiscuous at all, and I don't think that very many of them are going to go out and have affairs, and if they do, there's no way they're going to admit it. So that's got to be low, about 9 out of 100.
Nine is low.
Nine out of 100.
Play higher, lower, what do you think?
I don't think so. I really believe that today, especially in these big cities, people have just gotten outrageous with their morals. I'm going to say it's higher.
You're saying it's higher than nine.
Okay.
The actual number of married women who have had an affair is 15. It is. It is higher. So, Clay, here we go. To the board with you. You've gotten the high-low question correct. You can change this base card. Let's look at it right now. It's a duke.
Oh, I don't want to take it. I want to go higher.
You got to go higher than a two. A nine. Clay, a freeze. What do you want to
freeze?
Do? He's going to freeze. Okay, so Clay's going to freeze, protect his position, and realize, of course, that if he makes a mistake, he'd give Tina a free shot at the cards. Let's go on to our next question. It goes to you, Clay. We surveyed 100 lawyers who specialize in defending criminals, and we asked them, have you ever defended a person you believed was guilty? How many lawyers said they had?
Oh, I think it's part of their job. That's something they just have to do. That's part of what keeps our justice system working. So I'm going to say that's pretty high, about 55.
55 out of 100. Tina, high or lower? What do you say?
I think that that's got to be just a little bit higher, because if they're defending him, there's got to be more or less most of the time. If it was bad, then there's a reason why they're defending him. So I think it's just a little higher.
You're going to go higher. I'll tell you, I have a feeling that it is going to be higher and significantly so. Let's take a look at the answer, though. The actual number of lawyers who have defended...